everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I wanted to tell the story of what happened to my nose. I get asked this question a lot, sometimes in a curious way, and sometimes it's kind of a mean comment way, but regardless, I thought I would tell you guys this story because it's definitely not like my natural nose. There are things that happen to it. So let's dive into it. So when I was 10, we had these logs on the playground in elementary school. I don't think I can really show how big they were on camera, like something like that. Like they looked like cut off tree trunks. That's kind of the size they had. They were logs. And one day we were playing tag on them, and as I was jumping from one log to the other, I kind of hit or got onto the log with my toes, and I like slipped, and I don't know what I was like. It all went so fast, like I don't know what I was doing with my hands, but I toppled over the log with my nose straight onto the ground. And I remember just hearing like this big bang in my head. I don't particularly remember feeling pain. I think I was probably just in shock because I don't remember it like really hurting a lot. But I got up and I just saw blood everywhere. So I ran screaming to the teacher who was supervising the playtime that day. And judging by the horrified look on her face, I imagine that I looked horrible. Like, I can still remember the way she looked at me. So she took me into the canteen to use like the first aid kit on me. And the principal took me to the doctor. So we had a doctor at the end of the street where our school was. And I remember sitting in the hallway with my principal. He was wonderful. He was holding my hand and he was like talking me down and everything. And he said to me that the school got priority. So every person in the waiting room would have to wait. As soon as the person who was in with the doctor came out, we would be allowed to go in. So we did, and I don't know exactly what my nose looked like, but I imagine that the skin like split open or something because she had to stitch my whole nose back together. I also had a little piece of skin at the bottom hanging off that she had to tape. I still have a tiny little scar there. So she stitched everything up and then sent me back to school. So the principal, I don't think, called my parents at this point. Actually, my mom was at work. My dad was home. I don't think he called the principal at this point. I went back to class, and I don't remember how long I was there, maybe half an hour, and I like threw up all over my bed, my school bench. And because I'd swallowed so much blood, which I didn't realize that was the reason at the time, but like, needless to say, I was really sick. So that at that point, the principal called my dad to come pick me up, and my dad took me back to the same doctor, and she said, I threw up again in her office, and she said, well, I want you to take her for x-rays at the hospital to see if her nose is broken, and also to make sure that she doesn't have a concussion. concussion because the fact that I was throwing up made her worry that I had a concussion. And so the big thing about having a concussion is that you're not allowed to fall asleep. So my dad drove me to the hospital and I was lying down in the back seat and I kept falling asleep and I don't know why. I don't know if it was from the anesthesia that she'd put in my nose before she stitched it up or what was going on, but I kept falling asleep and my dad kept shouting at me to stay awake. And so he was convinced I had a concussion because I kept falling asleep. But they did all the x-rays and it turns out my nose wasn't broken and that I didn't have a concussion. I literally threw up that much because I'd swallowed so much blood and your stomach doesn't digest blood. So that was kind of that. I was home from school for a week. I remember this so well. My favorite movie is Dirty Dancing, and it already was back then. And it would be a movie, like in Belgium, you have really long days of school. You have school from like 8 or 8:30 until 4:30 every day, except for Wednesday, you have a half day of school. You have 8:30 until 12. And every Wednesday afternoon when I came home from school, I would watch Dirty Dancing. And so when I was home sick, well, with my nose, my mom let me watch Dirty Dancing every single day. But there is this one scene where baby tries to dance on the bridge and she keeps failing and she gets really frustrated and starts kicking the bridge, and it always makes me laugh really hard. And I just remember that everything was like, it was stitched up, like it didn't move, and I just remember laughing and it hurt so bad everywhere. I don't look like that's just a vivid memory I still have of that time. We also had to have class pictures taken the week after, and I still had stitches on my nose, and I had to put this like really bright orange stuff on it to disinfect it every day. So I walked into my class picture with like stitches and a bright orange nose, and the photographer positioned me in such a way that all the kids were facing forward and I was facing to the side. I am by far the odd one out in that class picture. I still have it. So that was all fine. That healed and everything. But as I got older, it started to grow a really big bump. But not like I would have had a little bit of a rounder nose anyway, because my mom and all my aunts and stuff do. But this wasn't like a normal rounded nose. This was like this and then like a bump and then back flat. It was a very like witch nose. It was a very unnatural bump. So when I was 16, I had cosmetic surgery done on my nose to bring it back to normal. I turned 17 in November. And I had it done in the summer, like when it was school holidays, because you're not allowed to do surgery on your nose until you're 17, because your nose I don't think it ever fully stops growing, but it stops growing for the most part when you're 17. If you do it before that, it changes too much in a couple of years. So I had it done, and they essentially just got rid of the bump, and she said to me that on the inside it was by no means straight, but they did it so that it looked straight from the outside. And honestly, you guys, it really does. I have no idea why a camera always picks it up so crooked. If I wasn't flipping my videos in mirror image, it would be like this. And even with flipping them, you can still see that this is like slightly crooked. And it is, for by all means it is, but you don't see it in life. You just see it in necessarily when you look at it, but it's definitely not completely straight either, especially on the inside. I can tell as well because I have one nostril that is much smaller than the other. Like, again, not on the outside, but on the inside, this side of my nose is just much smaller than this side of my nose. That surgery, it's the only time I've ever had surgery. It was not pleasant by any means. I, again, got very sick there because of swallowing blood. The room, they had, like, I don't want to get too into detail because that's just horrifying, but they had cotton pads that were all the way up into my sinuses to stop the bleeding, and let's just say when they removed them, I howled. Like, it was so painful. So I walked around with a cast on my nose. It's actually the thumbnail of this video, for a month. It was summer. The cast actually ended up falling off on its own before I got it removed because of the heat. Like, I was sweating so much, it just came off. And then I had to get the stitches on the inside removed, which again was extremely painful. I wasn't even crying because I was crying, but tears were streaming down my face from the pain. And I remember they actually forgot one stitch, which I only noticed a few days later, and I was too afraid to tell anyone because I didn't want to go back. So I told my parents like a month later. I was like, hey, I think they left a stitch behind. And she said, my mom said, you have to go back because that could get infected. But then it didn't hurt at all anymore because everything had healed. So thankfully, because I was dreading going back to get that done. But yeah, that is kind of it. I will say that someone asked me flat out in the comments one day, did you have plastic surgery done on your nose? I wondered actually whether that was someone I knew who just wouldn't say it, or whether that was genuinely because my nose looked a little bit weird. I did have plastic surgery done on it, and it's not something that I'm ashamed of. It is usually one of the first things people I meet know about me. It's not even, I don't know, like everyone at work knows about it. All my friends know about it. I always make them feel my nose at some point. When I first met my team, back in 2017, my manager wanted to play the game of two truths and one lie, like where you tell three things about yourself. One of them is a lie and people have to guess what it is. And one of mine was I had cosmetic surgery done on my nose. Like, I don't, it's not something that I don't want to tell people. Yes, I wouldn't have needed to get it done if it wasn't, that I fell on it, but I still think that if you are truly unhappy with how you look and there are ways to fix it, I don't see why you wouldn't. I can tell you this, I am a very outgoing, very chatty person, but I was not like that when I was younger. Having my nose changed really boosted my self-esteem. It made me into a much more confident teenager and a much more confident adult. And that, to me, was worth everything. There was nothing medically wrong with it. Like, I could breathe fine out of it. It wasn't hindering me in any way. But having said that, it was fully paid for by my medical insurance because I had medical records from when I fell on it. I went back to my elementary school. They had to dig deep to find the records from when I fell on it. But I got them, and my medical insurance paid for the whole thing. So I guess it was medically justified, but there was nothing really wrong with it. I did it purely for aesthetic reasons, and I have no shame about that. I think it's one of the best decisions I ever made because it really changed me kind of as a person and how I am in life. Yeah, I mean, like I said, it's by no know me is perfect. There's definitely, I think in this, because I filmed another video prior to this, and while I was editing it, I could tell that today it looks particularly crooked. I think I didn't highlight it very well, so a lot has to do with, like, lighting and stuff like that. But it's definitely not straight, and it never will be. So, yeah, that is it. I was really hoping to tell this story a little bit slower. I always want to start off slow, and then I get so enthusiastic that I end up going really fast. So, I hope that's okay. I hope it was still somewhat relaxing. And, yeah, thank you guys as always. Oh, that was my stomach. Sorry. Thank you guys as always so much for watching.